exercise 10 is all about hair rotor. We've cleaved out a huge amount of our image to remove the wire. Now it's time to be surgical and bring in hair strands. This can be a grueling job, but I'm going to share some tips to make it a lot easier and still have it looking great. All right, so that's looking promising. So now we've taken all of this stuff out with our Roto. We need to now bring in some of that interesting stuff back. So that interesting stuff is, well, we'll start with this part of the dress. And then we're going to tackle hair. Oh, hair. Fun. Fun, fun, fun. Let's not have all the fun right now. Let's do this part of the dress instead. Hair is great. I'm just gonna put that out there before we even touch a single strand. I'm just gonna say hair roto is gonna be a trip. There we go. Right, now watch what I'm doing with this shape again. Coming in here, I'm rotoing to the shape. I'm not caring too much about what's happening on the wire. So we're going to the bottom here on the dress. I'm following that invisible line around on the dress. Actually put it in our back area here. Let's start renaming our shapes as well. This is pure laziness to not do this. This one's going to be sky patch. This one's going to be dress holding. There we go. And I'll just quickly roto this in. Say quickly because it's going to be very quick. I can probably just do this with a few. I say quickly, it's going to be quick. And that's the last frame where we can really see it. It's right about there. I'll take it one more frame in. And then I can just click and click on this here to toggle the opacity. That sets a keyframe down the bottom. Go one more frame back and the opacity off. Just make sure that's looking all right. Cool. Let's get these things color coded. I'm happy with my sky patch, so I'll lock that up. And if I'm happy with my dress, which I am now, let's give that another color. And we'll lock that up. Let's invert that before I lock it up. So when we come to the composite again, yeah, that's going to work out fine. Okay. Hair. Now, hair roto is an interesting beast. Hair itself is not just this monolithic shape. I mean, if we were to try to tackle this as one shape, it would just be absolutely ridiculous. We wouldn't do it. We couldn't do it. So what we need to try to do is to isolate some of the hair strands out and think about those hair strands themselves. And this can take a little while to do, but it's absolutely worth it. To get the result, because there's nothing better than having, you know, good looking hair going across selling the shot. I'm also going to counsel against overthinking the hair as well. We're not here to do huge hair roto. We're here to do just enough hair roto so that the wire remove itself is invisible. And I'm saying this out loud, a little bit for you, but also for me, for when I start to work on this as well. I'm often get kind of carried away with this kind of stuff. So where do we start? Well, I always think we should start with getting a good track on the head. Because if we get a good track on the base of the head or where the hair is coming out from, that makes everything else so much easier. So I'm going to create up a new layer and I'm going to call this one hair and let's track this in. A point tracker it'll probably do a decent enough job, but I think for this, I'm going to use a Mocha tracker to turn on my overlays again so I can actually create new shapes. Yeah, I'm going to create a Mocha tracker here, but the Mocha tracker itself, I'm not going to do anything with shear, rotation, or scale. I just want translation. oftentimes if we try to get a bit too clever with this tracking, then it ends up working against us, basically, because we know with hair it's going to be moving around all over the place. So the only thing we're trying to do here is just to cancel out some of the main movement. Now we've tracked the hair in, because we used the Mocha tracker, we don't have to do anything else. Like, the tracking information is automatically applied to the layer as it tracks through. Because we've still got stabilization back on, we can see whether this is working or not. And it's doing quite well. Like, without stabilization, we're going to have to, you know, be chasing the camera move and our hair. With the stabilization, we've really just got the hair to worry about. I'll name this one track shape, turn off visibility, and lock it. We don't really need it. I could even just delete it, but we'll keep it there just to be safe. So now what do we do? Well, let's find a strand of hair. And I'm going to choose some of the big locks. I'll actually choose this big lock in the middle here. And I'll create a fairly simple shape for it. And I'm just trying to define the overall shape. Like, just trying to get this strand in. Now, if I was being extra specially picky about this, I would also come in here and try and get that little spike down at the bottom there. But I don't think that little spike crosses over, he says as he watches the spike cross over. Ah, okay, I'm glad I checked. So let's come into our regular reshape tool and we'll hold down the Alt key and add a few more points in here. I was hoping we could get away with that a little bit more. All right, but let's select that and we'll just tighten these curves up a little bit as well. Okay, that should be good. And I'm going to do something a little bit different on this one. Because we know where we want to cut out, on the hair layer itself, I'm going to just invert that straight away. And I'm going to come up to the top of the viewer and take this overlay down, the Rubylith overlay down. We can change the opacity up here at this value. The 15 is probably a bit, sorry, 10 is a bit light. 15 is probably a bit better for me. It means that if I hit the zero key to turn off the outlines, I can easily see where I am in the process. Great. Here's our first hair strand. And I'm going to be using two tools here. As I follow this through, first thing always is to try to use the transform tool, the T for transform tool, to transform it mainly into place itself. So I'm looking where this is sat on the hair. Hit A a couple of times. So it's this bit here. As that moves over, I'm watching where that goes and then moving that into place. Let's check to see whether that's moving in the right place, and it is. So the nice thing about hair is that once you've got the main movement of this strand in, we can come in and we can use our brush reshape tool to do most of the hard work for us. Pan around here. With the brush reshape tool, if I hold down the shift key, I can disable the magnetic behavior. So you can see that it's just shifting those points just in the X and Y. So if I need to just move things over just a little bit without actually pulling them, then I can do that with holding down the shift key and moving. And if I just move normally, I get my magnetic reshape tool behavior back again. Bring that up. I need to be a little bit careful here, because this is actually something that is being taken over by the wire. I just need to be sure that that is in place. And I see I've been confused. I've been bamboozled. This wasn't looking properly. I'm actually trying to shift in the wrong piece of hair. And that's, it happens. If I'm in the right piece of hair now, yes, I am. And that's starting to move a little bit better. Good, and when that goes off, then I will do the little opacity trick over here. I'm going to call this hair strand one. Good luck giving these hair strands useful names rather than hair strand 1, 2, 3, and 4. And we'll take it back onto the other side. So I'm going to look where that's going, to around about there. That's it. And then I'm going to use the Alt key or Option key just to try and warp as much of that stuff into place as I can before coming into the reshape. So the more we can do with the transform tool, obviously the better. Do I have to worry too much about what's going on down here? No. And the reason for that is simple. It doesn't really affect what's happening with the wire. So it does affect what's happening in this big overall patch shape. So we do have to be aware a little bit, but we're going to be fading the patch shape out. That's mainly where it crosses over the wire that we have to worry about things. Okay, one strand down, only another couple to go. Okay, so hair strand one locked. Let's get to the next one. I'm going to do this one here. And you can just watch me do these next few strands. If there's anything different or interesting that pops up, I will let you know. But you know, most of this is just a case of repetition now. That's one thing to note here is that because the hair is very 3D and we're trying to mask it or roto it in 2D, sometimes you really just have to think about what shape it is that you're creating. You know, so don't be afraid to kind of move the shape in a more sympathetic way. And also don't be afraid to break up complex shapes into multiple strands as well. You know, just use some of the regular roto guides and regular roto ideas when you're doing this. I'm not going to be too fussy about what's going on here as well, because this is well away from where the wire is. All right, I've got another couple of big strands to do, but we're getting there. It's very easy to lose strands in the mix. So we just have to make sure that when all these things are going over each other, that when it comes out the other end, that everything is still covered as it should be. This is a complete mess here, which is why I started with the hair strands from the other side, because that was obviously a lot easier to see. It just means that it's very simple to, or very very easy, I should say, just to kind of lose where the particular locks are going. But we just want to keep overall movement, overall shapes. Make sure things are looking as expected. Okay, so we've got several of our strands done now. Let's take a quick look at how that looks in the comp. Look at it how it looks right now. Zoom out a little bit. Let's just play that back. There we go. Not bad. Not bad. Not bad. We can do one more thing. And this is going to help us out to get a lot of the other strands that we're missing. And let's come over to our roto now. Zoom around here. And that's to create one more shape that's just going to be our wire. And I'm going to come in. I'll actually apply that same tracking node that we had here onto my wire. Let's come to our tracker. Have that selected. Have my wire selected here. Go to the point tracker and go apply. There we go. The nice thing about trackers is that we can just reuse them many, many times. And I'll just do a very, very, very quick wire shape here. Go, and we'll just move that through as we need to. Make sure that's covered there, and Bring them in there. Them over here. There's a lot of guesswork now. You just have to guess that the wire is going to be straight, which it is, you know, but we just need to sort of, yeah, just be comfortable using our best guess and make sure that that is covering the wire all the way through, which is good. Good, good, good. Okay, so let's start combining these. So I've got my wire, which is in black. Let's blur this out just a little bit. Blur this outwards. That should be fine. Come up. And we're going to stack these in a certain order. So let's turn off the hair so that we're not confused about what's going on there. I'm going to bring my wire over my back. And I'm going to set the blend mode of the wire here to multiply. So this is going to blend my wire and my back together to give us just the areas where, you know, things are crossing over. It means when my back comes in here, that's going to look nice. Okay. And on top of that, now let's bring the hair back in. The hair should be at the right level. Let's look at that there. Excellent. That's looking pretty good. I could blur the hair up. I can add some motion blur to it. We'll do all of that in a little bit, but this is just an idea of how that patch is going to look now. So let's see if that works or if we need to do a little bit more work to it. Off of the alpha, come back into our composite. There we go. So now we can see that all we have to do is just start to fill in some more of the hair strands, and this is going to start looking really nice. And this technique is going to work. This exercise has been about how to bring our hair back. We've made good use of the last of the triumvirate of tracking tools in Silhouette to help stabilize the viewer. But most importantly, we've talked about how doing the least amount of work possible isn't laziness. It's actually one of the best ways to get a consistent result. So I'm going to leave you there for now, and I'm going to fill in some more hair strands off camera. If I do anything interesting or different, obviously we'll look at that when we return. So I'll be back shortly with a bit more rotoed hair.